Stream Bean is not feeling yes. well.
Right, right.
So we wish you a speedy recovery, yes. Trina Braxton. We yes. love you so much, but
absolutely.
We want you to be well
yes,
and at
do.
Your
yes.
best
yes.
when
yep.
you're down to the circle.
Yes.
Yes. Well, ladies, how are you feeling?
Oh, we're feeling like $1 million.
And looking yes. like it too.
Hello,
come on
somebody.
Now. It's a Tuesday, Miss Kwai.
It
what
is.
Type of Tuesday are we having today?
Timing Tuesday.
Timing Tuesday.
And I want to encourage you guys to reassure you that everything happens that's supposed to happen mm-hmm. in due time.
In due yes. time.
Timing Tuesday.
I love that, Miss
yeah.
Kwai.
Yeah,
you
right. Something for the people.
Yes.
Well, what's today? It's a lot of pink and green
ooh,
in this
yeah.
little nipple yes, section.
Yes, you don't notice.
Trinkets.
You don't notice.
Oh, it has a little green on her watch.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, yes, my watch.
What time is it?
It's 1908.
Is it 1908? Yes.
Yes, it is the Founders Day of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority
yes.
Incorporated, January 15th, 1908. But before we get into that, let's introduce the people to our show.
Well, why not?
Hello, I am Rashawn Ali.
I'm Selena
yes.
Johnson.
Okay,
yes.
I forgot to introduce. It's such a circle
right.
that you're watching.
Yes, yes. I'm just a robot, and I just know I hear that. So
right,
I'll go
it's time to go.
All right, then they have me on the camera, so
right.
I just want to introduce myself to you. Hi, guys, how are you? I'm yours truly, Miss
Kwai. I love it. I love it. I'm all over the place today, and it's for a good reason. Well, this is Sister Circle Live. We do have an amazing time. It's sisterhood personified.
It
this is
that.
What you see is what you get. Like, we really are cool.
Yeah.
Like, for real, in real life.
Now you hear the word kind of being thrown around here and there. Sisterhood. Mm. We're sisterhood.
Got it.
This is a sister.
Yes, yeah, it is. Yes.
Yeah.
And speaking of
yeah.
which, Sister Circle Savings is going down today.
Don't
we are back at it with some great deals just for you.
Yes.
And as mentioned earlier, yes, it is my Founders Day, our Founders Day, January 15th, 1908. I am a proud member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated for the last 24 years.
Yes,
in the bond for 24
Jesus.
Years. Yes, and over the weekend, had an amazing time on Metro Atlanta Founders Day. That is our national president, Dr.
Yes.
Glenda Baskin Glover, who's also the president of Tennessee State University.
She
just
sure
an
is.
Amazing, amazing, amazing time this past weekend. Of course, we kicked the weekend off with a community service effort as we made care packages for, yeah, that's Danny. Yes, care packages for local. Yes, absolutely. She's from Memphis. Absolutely. I got the good people down.
Tennessee State, okay.
Yes, absolutely. So we made care packages for local HBCU students under our HBCU for Life initiative. We've already donated millions of dollars to HBCUs and we'll continue to do that. Just an amazing time. But I also got to spend the Saturday where we had a huge luncheon with my mother, who's been an AKA for 54
aww.
Years. There she is right there seated. So I got the chance to spend time with her, which is always, always very, very special. My Spring 94 big sisters celebrating their 25 years. So just happy to celebrate with them. Just a beautiful, beautiful time. And like you said, Kwai, yesterday, you know, just being around your sororers and your friends, it's just a beautiful feeling of sisterhood.
It is.
And, it's gorgeous. I mean, January is all of our months.
My
so
God.
We got Selena tomorrow.
Coming through. Real blue light tomorrow.
Right, blue light tomorrow. But today the pink is on flashing.
Cool.
That's right. The light is, yeah, absolutely. So shout out to all my sorors of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority
yes.
Incorporated on 111 years of service. All mankind.
And, but you know what? Shout out to MPHC.
Absolutely.
And shout out to all the African American Greek organizations.
Mm-hmm.
You know, every time we have an anniversary, it is big.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. For the men and the women.
Absolutely.
So just happy anniversary, Rashawn.
Thank
happy
you.
Anniversary,
yes.
Kwai.
Thank
again.
You so much.
Yes.
And also happy anniversary.
It's
you
coming
got next.
It's coming through.
Coming through with the blue.
But yes, just all of us.
Yes,
I'm proud
yeah.
of all of us
yeah.
and what we represent over the years.
Yes, yeah. and absolutely. And the fact that we get to be able to represent our organization
yes.
on a national
yes.
platform.
Yes.
I know you
it's
all
so
hear that
dope.
From your sororers every
it's
time
so
you
dope.
Thank you for representing. Thank you for
yes.
representing.
Yes.
And it's
God,
like,
yes.
it's a
yes.
big deal that we get to do that and
yes,
have
ma'am.
The responsibility
yep.
and the platform.
Yes, and it's good for intake.
It's good for
and it's
everything.
A positive platform. We show true sisterhood.
It is. Yeah.
I'm just, we doing our thing.
We might be. We might be.
Might be.
Might be.
We are.
We are. You're absolutely right. Y'all ready to talk about what's going on in the world?
Why not?
Let's Let's do it. So let's get to the top of our daily feed. Well, as a result of the overwhelming criticism for agreeing to perform during the Super Bowl halftime show, Travis Scott revealed that before signing on as a headliner, he made a stipulation to the NFL, a joint donation of $500,000 to Dream Corps, a nonprofit organization that champions social justice. I like the fact that he did this. What say you, ladies?
Absolutely. Yeah. So let me ask you this. Mm-hmm. A joint. Is he matching? Are they matching
him? I hope they're matching.
Or is it 250
and 250? I think they're, I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I know it's going to be at least $500,000 given to this particular organization.
Well, regardless of if they're matching or not, I just really love that he was courageous enough, mm-hmm. first of all, to mm-hmm. say, I'm going to do it, and then I'm going to do it with some stipulations.
Absolutely.
And then second of all, you know, you have to think, and I know what this means for us to boycott it. Mm-hmm. I know what it means, and we are making a statement. Mm-hmm. But as an artist, maybe that's a dream of his to have always wanted
Absolutely.
To perform at the NFL. Mm-hmm. Now, where does that fine line, mm-hmm. you know, where do we toe the line on that?
Right.
Should someone give up their dreams too?
Mm.
Like, we have to ask ourselves that, you know what I'm saying? Should someone give up their dreams all the time just to sacrifice for the greater good?
Wow. But I'm glad. That's a great
You're
statement.
Saying, I thought about that, like, it's deep though. What if that was a dream of his as a child?
With the stipulation, I think he makes not only himself feel good.
He makes it purposeful.
Absolutely, and he's helping other people in
exactly.
the process.
That's exactly what I was gonna say, Rashawn. Here's something that could have been bad or maybe people have perceived as a negative, and he's turning around for good.
Absolutely.
There's gonna be a number of people who are gonna reap the benefits of this. Mm-hmm. So, you know, what can come out of something that is good?
Mm-hmm.
Nothing but good.
Absolutely.
So that's what it was. He meant it from the heart. I truly believe that.
Mm-hmm.
Great job, Travis.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Shout out to Big Boy, who will be gracing the stage as well. Well, SAG-AFTRA issued a statement saying they've received several reports that the Academy has been pressuring actors to appear only at the Oscars, despite the fact that there are many award shows between now and the Academy Awards that takes place on February the 24th. In a statement, the Actors Union calls the Academy out for using, quote, self-serving intimidation to limit actors' opportunities to be seen and to be honored. Many sources are speculating that the Academy is attempting to fill the void of a host with exclusive appearances by the biggest names in Hollywood. So they're trying to bully the people.
They tripping.
Trying to bully the
SAG
people.
SAG is tripping. They've been tripping for a minute.
Oh, my goodness.
They've been tripping behind
the scenes. It's the Academy Awards that's tripping. The SAG and AFTRA has issued a statement like, don't do this to our actors.
So the
Academy is the
so
one.
The Academy, are they mad at Kevin Hart?
Yeah, well.
They mad? Is that what's going
this
on?
This is what it is. They don't want them to go to any other award shows. I just need you to show up at ours.
How can you do that,
you
though?
You can't.
How can you tell someone what to do and what not to do? This is a contrary free will. I don't understand this.
Yes.
And so they're going to debo the people.
Yes.
No.
They're
going to make somebody go. What if they don't want to go to your thing either? What if they had something to do?
But
what if they have other things? What if they can't make it? They wasn't going in the first place.
How unfair is that?
That is unfair.
And what gives them the tenacity to say, this is what you should do?
Yeah.
I don't understand it.
Well, they think they're the big dogs. They are the premier awards.
Let them tell
it. Yeah, exactly. For actors and actresses.
Okay, so what's going to be the consequence if you show up at another award show?
I have no idea.
Nothing.
That's why the complaint has been issued. We shall see.
That'll be gone out the news next week. That's crazy. They sound crazy.
Yes.
That's crazy.
Yes, well, something that is continuing to be in the news is R. Kelly. Now, a press conference yesterday of an alleged victim of sexual assault by R. Kelly said she received threats of retaliation for both her participation in the Surviving R. Kelly docuseries and a civil lawsuit she filed against him. Gloria Allred, who is representing other alleged victims, released a copy of a letter they saw was from R. Kelly threatening to damage her client's reputation. At the conference, Gloria stated that R. Kelly may soon join the ranks of Bill Cosby and Harvey Weinstein. She went on to say that he can look forward to a legacy which will not be his music, but rather the pain and suffering he inflicted on many vulnerable teenagers and young women who claimed they were victimized by you. And that is a quote from Gloria Allred. But, you know, to think about this woman who is taking a step forward.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the alleged victims have chosen to not come out, but she is one of the very few, if not the first.
Yeah, the first.
To say.
Since the two investigations have been launched in Chicago and then also here in Fulton County.
Right. So this story is continuing to unfold. And we will keep you updated on it. It's something new every single day.
Well, I just want to take a moment and really salute her.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a lot to come out when everyone has an opinion, mm-hmm. when everyone is criticizing, when everyone is judging. Your strength is going to be the strength of so many other women yeah. to come forward.
Yes.
So be proud of yourself. Move forward with
tenacity.
How about that?
I love it.
How about that?
Yes.
Do that, sister.
Gotcha.
All right.
So we will definitely keep you updated on this and more. Well, Essence announced their 2019 Women in Hollywood honorees, and they are Kiki Layne, whose breakout performance in If Beale Street Could Talk has thrust her into the forefront, Amanda Steinberg.
Woo! She's so cute.
Yes, she is. She generated much buzz with her role in The Hate U Give. And rounding out the honorees are a pair of veterans beloved by all, Regina Hall and Jennifer Lewis, honey. I love both of them.
Yeah. Of course.
All four ladies graced the cover of Essence's film noir issue, available on newsstands January the 25th. Look at all of this magic in one place. Loving to see the young mm-hmm. women, mm-hmm. you know, being recognized for not only their talent, but their activism mm-hmm. as well. These young babies not playing.
No, they're not
Do
playing
Do you find
radio.
That they really did that more, like, when we were coming up? That it wasn't that many young mm-hmm. people
It was not.
Being activists, or was it?
I
don't remember.
No, yeah. I would say no, it wasn't, or it wasn't really being highlighted. I think people were looking at younger kids as kids mm-hmm. and not looking at them as an actual person who has a voice.
Mm-hmm.
And I think what we see now is that anyone can use their platform for the greater good of the people.
Right, right.
Absolutely.
And mm-hmm. now we're listening.
And now we are seeing that every mm-hmm. single day. Well, a video of a UCLA gymnast, Caitlin Ohashi, flawlessly earning herself a perfect 10, has officially broken the internets, racking up more than 150,000 retweets and over 500,000 likes as of this morning. Not only does her routine appear effortless, but the backstory is that she was in a car accident just last year, and she helped mm-hmm. UCLA win an NCAA title. She's been very vocal about her body issues while competing, and for her to have this perfect 10 is absolutely
that girl body banging.
Look at this.
Get
and she's
girl.
Having fun while she's
doing
it.
Up.
Oh, yes!
Turning up.
You better, girl. You better. Come on, Caitlin.
Yes.
Yes.
She hit him with the robot.
Yeah. Awesome. Congratulations, Caitlin. Up next, we've got more stories for you in our daily feed. Don't miss out. Stay right where you are.
Yeah, she was doing her thing.
Yes,
wasn't
she was.
And her body shine.
Yes. Welcome back to our amazing show. It's called Sister Circle Live. If you see three of us, it's because Trina Braxton is not feeling
she's
that
sick.
Well today.
No,
we wish
she's
she was
struggling
yesterday.
Oh my gosh, she struggled.
We love you, we love you. Okay, so we're going to continue our daily feed with Serena Williams, honey. She maintained her reputation for making statements with her on-court fashion at the Australian Open yesterday. She wore a green mint Nike bodysuit and
so
fishnet
bad.
Tights. Mm. And the fans absolutely loved it. I love this tweet. This is a tweet from somebody. Serena Williams' Australian Open outfit is giving me more life than my mother's womb. I love it. And after she won the match, she dubbed her jumpsuit a Serena-tard and said the outfit was designed to make an incredibly strong, powerful statement for mothers that are trying to get back and get fit. You better do it, Serena.
Mm-hmm.
We love you.
She's so bad.
Ain't she?
And she's consistent with it.
Yeah,
she's consistent
that.
Winning and greatness.
I love it. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
My God.
I love this, and I know Selena Johns is gonna love this story. Shout out to the Houston Rockets shooting guard, James Harden, who played his 17th consecutive game, scoring at least 30 points against the Memphis Grizzlies. This marks the longest streak since Wilt Chamberlain had 20 straight 30-point games in 1964. And he breaks Kobe Bean Bryant's record of 16 straight 30-point games. Congratulations to James Harden, doing your thing.
James Harden is snapping.
He is.
I tell you, he's managed to get all these points and not play a lick of defense. Look at that.
Well, if you have a thought like that, send us your thoughts at Sister Circle TV.
Good job.
That's right. Up next, we've got some amazing morning save deals just for you. Don't miss out. Poor James Harden.
That's not a stitch.